All right, everybody. Oh, happy day. In this video, I'm going to share with you a question that I get asked so much. I run a national insurance agency, jasonfinalexpense.com. I'm so blessed to partner with some amazing people across the nation. I'm so proud of them. But let me tell you, I get asked this question so much from my YouTube viewers, as well as brand new agents when they first hop on. They're like, how many non-resident licenses do I need? How many states do I need to be successful in the telespace? And let me tell you, I'm gonna get after it. So I hope this video helps you gain perspective, gets you the answer that you need so that you can make, okay, the rational decision for yourself and capitalize on the opportunity. So if this video helps you, feel free to like it, and by all means subscribe if this helps you. So how many licenses do you really need? How many states do you need? Let me tell you, the question demands a question back, right? The question that you should ask yourself, if you're debating the first question, how many states do I need? You need to ask yourself, are you going to be an inbound agent or are you going to be an outbound insurance agent? If you're outbound, you don't need a crap ton of states. You just don't. One state is fine, more than fine. Okay, I would pass away in this chair, okay, if I was doing just outbound leads. Outbound leads does not demand lots of states. It's not going to make you a lick more money. Having a ton of states that you're licensed, that you can tell all your buddies, wow, I'm licensed with every state in the union. I just spent thousands of dollars to go get licensed across the state lines everywhere. It's not going to make you more wealthy. It just won't. You want to get wealthy, and you would think sometimes that if I have a bunch of states, I'm going to make more money and be more successful. But it's not the truth, you guys. If anyone's telling you that, they're lying to your face, okay? If you're doing outbound insurance, one state, the state that you're a resident of, with the exception of New York and Florida, all right? Always put a caveat there. But if you are in one big state with enough population density, if you're doing outbound insurance, my goodness, you'd pass away in your chair and you still wouldn't talk to everybody that you wanted to, okay? There's too many people. It's amazing. Thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands of people are turning 65 every day. It's like 11,000 people. Okay, in America, are turning 65 every day. It's mind-blowing. So focus, absolutely focus on one state if you're doing outbound. It won't hurt you to have two if you're in a small state because you're like, you know what, I work this state a lot. You know, I just want to try this other one. Then go for it. There's nothing wrong with that, but it's very inexpensive to just add one state to your, okay, resident state that you have already. So it's not a big, like, cash dump. Okay, when you're in inbound, if you're answering the question goes, okay, how many states do I need? And you're like, I want to be an inbound agent. I want to sit right here. You make my phone ring. If that's the case, you're going to need probably around 10 to 13 states. Okay, you don't need any more than that. Get the big ones. Get the top states. You're going to be fine. But you want to make sure that as an inbound insurance agent that you're staying busy enough. Outbound insurance agents control everything. We control the dial. We control when we pick up the phone. As an inbound agent, let me tell you, sometimes you're just like sitting, okay, playing thumb wars with yourself, waiting for your phone to go off. And then when the phone, hello, right? You're caught off guard. Inbound leads, you must be just as prepared as outbound. You got to be ready. As mind-numbing as it is, you've got to be ready for that inbound lead to hit. You cannot be distracted. It'll cost you a lot of money. You can't be preoccupied. It'll also cost you even more money. Clients know if you're paying attention to them. Clients know if you're not. So you cannot be distracted. No distractions, whether you're inbound or outbound. But if you're wondering how many states do you need, if you're outbound and you're in a decent state, one is fine. Have two if you want to, okay? It's not necessary. It really isn't. Most of my career, you don't need a bunch of states. It's just not going to make you a ton of money. A lot of people think, oh, if I have all the states in the world, I'm going to be wealthy. It's all about your sales skills. It's all about your script. It's all about your training. It's all about your drive, okay? And are you focusing on the most important thing at every given minute? Having a ton of states won't make you a ton more wealth. But you know what? Having one or two states and doing outbound sure will. Or having 10 to 13 states and having the right states hand-selected for you. And doing inbound is great. I've got tons of agents that partner. I'm so proud of them. They do inbound leads. There's no shame in inbound. But you've got to be ready. You've got to be ready, so that when that phone rings, you're not surprised by it. You're prepared, all right? So be prepared, be profitable, be successful. But I hope this answers your question. How many states do you need? Well, you ask the question to yourself, am I going to be an inbound agent or an outbound agent? If you're outbound, the state you've got, okay, for your license plus one more, you're golden. And really, if you're in a big state, the second state isn't even necessary. You'll be too busy running and gunning and helping great people. But if you're an inbound agent, you will need a lot more states. If not, what'll take place is you're just going to be like sitting on your hands, and that's not fun. You won't have enough states, okay, like a funnel. Your funnel's too small doing inbound. You won't get many calls at all. So you really have to have lots of states, about 10 to 13 states to really stay busy, okay, especially if you're using like a TV lead vendor or maybe another inbound lead source. It just takes them a little. They got to do a lot more work, and they got to have a big funnel to keep you busy because they're going to funnel those leads to you. If you only got one or two states, it's not going to be adequate for inbound, okay? So if you're working for an inbound agency, you're really going to need 10 to 13 states on average. But you can pick the right ones so you don't go broke buying a bunch of states. When you're brand new starting out, my opinion, just my opinion, everybody, is you should be putting that money into leads to meet needs. When you first start out, go outbound if you can, unless you're sitting on a huge pile of cash where money's no option. But really focus on getting your skills down, get honed up and sharpened up. So now that you're better prepared to serve, okay, these great folks, to put $1,000 into a bunch of non-resident states that doesn't make you any revenue in return is kind of unwise. I don't think that's the best choice. Just my opinion, you guys. That's my 2 cents for you. So, all right. How many states do you need? If you're outbound, all right, onesie, twosie, you're good. And really, you don't need the second one if you're in a good, okay, high, you know, population state. But if you're going inbound, everybody, then go the other route and have 10 to 13 hand-selected states. Good to go. Have a good funnel. Take care, folks. There's nothing wrong with inbound either. I got great partnered agents that do both. Be successful. Hope this answers your question. Have a phenomenal day and a better day tomorrow. Thanks, you guys. I appreciate you watching.